Okay. We have to. Okay, so this is a guide session for Wish. So the for the Wish trailer two, the cartography mural, Wish trailer two, is the forest mural. Wait, no, it's that's the palace mural. So like the one, the forest mural was in the first trailer, was in the teaser trailer. The palace mural is the one that shows you the forest, the throne, and Lithia in the garden. So like the palace mural, like now that people have gotten access to the forum to view the Frozen Three Atlas, like now the trailer two is going to reveal the palace mural, and they are going to be like the Seven Majors Palace is going to receive visual like information from Lithia and the garden, and like they're going to view like the Obsidian Reservoir. They're going to view like the Lithia's resources independent of the Seven Majors, the garden's relationship with Lithia, and like then like also like how we've like sealed the portals. Like we're going to see how all of the portals have been sealed, and like how that Hito that we saw there, like King Magnifico, has been restored because the portals are closed. I think that maybe is like representative of him not having to like go searching like for girls or whatever, and like going into like people forcing me to go like do shit for their daughters is probably what that symbolizes. And so then like the those six, so like the six, like it was the 11 realms is what was happening. It's like that's what the battle was and like kind of is. And so like Sleeping Beauty is like a really important one, and that's like in we kind of saw a Sleeping Beauty kind of aspect to what was happening with Eugene. And like they Asha said, I make this wish, and like that was because she saw my like wishing well tower. That was how I got brought here. I didn't know that that was what happened. And so like Asha made this wish, and that was how the trailer manifested. And so then the second wish, or at least like what your guys is, those five boys were making a wish in the Eros temple, because like they came with those ropes. Like that was like kind of like our away equivalent. And so like they came with those ropes. That's the second wish, because we saw the six films, and like that's so there's five films to be presented. And then like Wish, I think is like the 12th. I don't know if that I don't really know. Like there were five children there, so presumably that's the second wish. That's the 11 realms. And then like the 12th is just like that's just it. That's just 12. Like that's just the movie, or I don't know. But I don't know if Wish is like a part of the films, but like they made a wish of in the Eros Temple of those five. Like they made a wish in the Eros Temple. Of those five boys made a wish in the Eros Temple, and like they are directing us and like guiding us to the five films that are going to be presented in the full trailer. Whether that is like directly like they were in the teaser, or if they're just gonna allude to it, I don't know. But I'm picking up that that's what I'm picking up what you're putting down. And so I think that that's what that is that like those five boys, that's like where you like visually they're guiding us to the second wish. And so I think that that's what it is. And like they're trying to restore something there. And so that's what's happening. And so like the guide session is like those, like the five films that are going to be presented in the full trailer are going to be representative of the Seven Majors' visibility of Lithia in the garden. And what that, like, so we went over this yesterday, or me and Gavin Bennett went over this yesterday, I think. Or no, it was me and Josh. We went over this yesterday of how like the Seven Majors King is like that is kind of like the visual representation of that can be like similar to what we saw of Chief Benja and Raya, like the guardians of that like water spirit thing. Like that's what the three like that's how like the like inhabitants of the Seven Majors the garden in Lithia will operate when like the server is A online and then also like accessible to like me and my actual friends, because that's the only way like in person like with like the four people like together, like that's the only way that we're doing this, like, and it's not going to be with any of my family members, like I'm not doing that. But yeah, so like that's what it is. Like that's how the game is going to work. It's like Sandcraft Online and like the like the controllers like playing it like together. Like that's how the game is going to work. It's like the people in the seven majors will be like in the seven majors, like how it'll work is it'll be kind of like similar to like the Guardians of like that water gem spirit thing. It's like the king there like is the water spirit, is like the spirit, or like the like that 10-year-old version of me is like the spirit, and like the gamers are going to be like interacting with that like version of me and like the libraries and like the recollections of me, the documentaries of me, like, and again, it's not like that's not the point of it, but like I think what it is that it's like it's not just going to be like there's like these like giant statues of me and like, you know, like King Midas statues or Ambrosia statues or anything. It's really just going to be a matter of like that the spirit of that region is going to be like the Royal Genome, for example, is probably like the Royal Genome, for example, is the wish like in the seven majors, like that's like what the spirit is. And so like that's in Dil's house. And so like that's what the spirit is. It's like, and even like the regions that have like specified people's like YouTube channels or whatever, like however people actually interact with it, because all I did was present how we could interact with it. Like however it actually takes shape is, that's another story. But like, so the Royal Genome, for example, is kind of like that 10-year-old, that first decade version of me, of like me and Dylan's like genetic identity and when we were closest to each other, like literally like womb birth. And so like, that's kind of what it is. It's just a spirit like in Raya. It's not that like you actually have to interact with a 10-year-old version of me whenever we play the game. It's just that like the spirit there is the Royal Genome. And like, that's where like the guardian of the Royal Genome is. It's just my spirit. It's just that like, that's what that spirit is, what's permeating the seven majors in the garden, like in the Garden Conservatory, like, the spirit, I don't know, like, so the 20 years of my life, so that was, like, when I was in college. So, like, the Garden Conservatory probably is more representative of, like, my relationships, like, my, like, platonic relationships with females and just, like, how I was very liberated and very liberal. Probably has a lot to do with what my, like, intelligence and my, like, genuine independence, because, like, that was when I, like, was not in therapy, but then also, like, not in high school. And so, like, I think that that's really, like, I think that that's kind of what that would symbolize, is like, that was just like the highest level of like independence that I have like experienced, but like it wasn't fully realized because like there was like fake student loan debt and like all this bullshit that was happening to me and like people like failing me on purpose and shit. But like still, like that was the closest that I had gotten to like genuine independence. And so I think that that's what's like represented in the like Garden Conservatory. And, like, that is, like, kind of what the spirit of the Garden Conservatory is. It says, like, some, like, representation of my, like, liberal mindset and, like, my, like, genuine, like, educational, like, mindset. And then, like, the in Lithia, it's, like, that is, like, the 30-year-old version of me where it's, like, it's organic and it's, like, present. And, like, it has gone through the hierarchy and it has, like, like, it is, like, a fully cohesive, like, depiction of me that then you can actually, like, call me and be, like, hey, like, I just, like, you know, I was just, you know, I was talking to, like, you know, the spirits in the seven majors, and I was talking to the spirits in the garden, and, like, I talked to the spirits in Lithia, and then I, like, you know, I'm just, like, hey, you know, FaceTime, yeah, and I'm, like, hey, just thought I'd say hi, because, like, you're an actual human being, and, like, I have access to you now, and it's, like, yeah, sweet, like, you know what my brain looks like now, and it's like, yeah, I really like your brain, and I'm like, yeah, I like you too, like, you're pretty cool, and then we're not trapped in the mirror anymore, we're not Beauty and the Beast anymore, and, like, that's how it works. But yeah, and so, like, the spirit in the seven majors, I would say that that's probably, like, in the, like, lakes of Lithia, like, in the air, like, where the Eros Temple, the Dionysus Temple, and the Aphrodite Temple are. Like, I'm, like, my brain is kind of naturally going to that area. So, like, maybe, I don't know, I don't think it should be in the Soul 70 Chambers, because it has to correspond with, like, the other two kingdoms. So, like, it seems it's probably that lake. it might be the lake itself. Like, as I don't know if it necessarily needs to, this one probably doesn't necessarily need to be like as strictly guarded, because like the royal genome, the spirit in the seven majors is in Dil's house. Because like we were children and we had to be in a house. And so like it had to be like very tightly guarded, very close knit, kind of like family oriented. And then like the spirit in the garden is like more free. It's in the garden conservatory. It's lavish. It has some personality to it. It's got like, it's like kind of like tucked away, but also like very accessible by the river. And like, it's just like really quaint. And like, it has like these like really nice, like kind of like pristine houses. And they're just like, and like they're like open houses, like real, like, and like they don't even have roofs. Like, I think that's really cool. It's just like really like sexy and chic. And I think that that's kind of what that is. And so like that kind of symbolizes like openness and like liberalism and like open communication. But it's also like, it is like housed, but it's not like totally like, it's not like claustrophobic, and it's not like really like tightly like family controlled or anything like the royal genome spirit is. And so like that's kind of how that spirit, like the independent spirit in the garden, is. And then like the but it's still like very much like man-made. It's like it's housed in like a man-made structure. And so I think that that kind of is still symbolized of how like me being trapped in Kansas, and like the sense that like I was not able to like be nomadic and just like really just like explore the world and just like have like genuine independence. Like it's still like reflective of that. And it's kind of, it's by that, like that artificial lake that we created in the garden, but it's like, it's actually tucked away in those mountains and like in those neighborhoods, because it's still like being housed and so kind of contained and kind of like somewhat claustrophobic. And so then in the lakes of Lithia, like the spirit in Lithia is like, that one is more symbolic of my like genuine and like reconstructed brain and like my authentic reconnection with my identity and like my awakeness. I think it probably, that one probably has a lot to do with like awakeness. So like the seven majors one is like genetics. The garden one is like independence. And the seven majors, and so the seven majors one is genetics. The garden one is independence, and the Lithia one is awakeness. And I think that that's really what it is. So it's like, and like that's in the Lake of Lithia. That's like by the Aphrodite Temple, the Soul Symphony Chambers, and the Healing Realm. Is that it's like that lake there is like the lake that symbolizes, it's like this, that spirit symbolizes like unity, and it symbolizes like awakeness in the sense of like, that is a really expansive lake that anybody, like, it's not like tightly guarded. It's not like closed off. It's connected to the garden river. It's connected to the seven majors. Like, it's connected to the Garland Parliament building. It's connected to the seven majors passageway. It's connected to Kumandra and Arendelle. It's connected to like my, like the Hollywood depictions of me. It's connected to that Egyptian pyramid. It's connected to like that waterway really like is like the like spiritual like epicenter of the Sandcraft Online server, really. And so like that's really what it is. It's like the awakeness of me like having like the like full like access to my like spiritual, to my like spirituality and my like conscious identity and my like conscious awareness and my intelligence and like just my, the knowledge that I have amassed throughout my life. And I think that that's kind of me giving that like full access to my brain, to myself, and like full access to myself, and full access to my, of my identity to myself, is that it's like, I'm like waking and like really like establishing a place for my like most conscious self that people can access. Now in my brain, you know, where like when you guys are like doing the awakening signals, you know, like even if like I am at a point where I'm not like, you know, like being distracted and like falling asleep, like throughout my life people might need to do the awakening signal for whatever reason. And so like now that you have this like this current map of my brain, it's like, oh, okay, so like that's where like naturally the spiritual energy of the awakening and of the cultural renaissance, like it naturally coalesced in the where the spirit of Lithia is. And I think that that's really cool. And so, like, now people know that, like, the spirit of Lithia is, like, that lake is the awakening lake. And, like, so now people know, like, okay, like, that's where we go, like, in our brains, in our minds, and in my mind, to go and be like, hey, like, this is where the spiritual awakening is. Like, this is where we go to have him at his, like, maximum, to have him, like, when he, like, kind of like Aang in the Avatar state, like, this is where we go when we really, like, when he's, like, really, like, has to be, like, when we need him in, like, you know, at full power. And, like, or just, like, when, like, we just, like, want to see him at his, like, most genuine. Because I think that was what was happening, is, like, she said, show yourself, like, what will you stand for? Because, like, I showed what my civilization would stand for. I showed what, like, these demonstrations of, like, these, like, military demonstrations, and I've shown, like, you know, artistic demonstrations. So I think now, like, Lionel Henry lifestyle, she's saying, like, show yourself what you're going to stand for, like, what your lifestyle, like, what you're going to stand for in your lifestyle, and just, like, in your personal life, in your, like, actual life, your genuine, authentic life, what do you stand for? And I think that that's, like, where the, like, most, like, authentic representation of me, like, my brain, when I think of the question of what will you stand for in your own life, like, it is, like, the lakes of Lithia. It's, like, that spirit, that spiritual height of awakenedness, and that, like, just, like, that connectedness to, like, the environment and to the earth and to Lanai and to the future and to, like, the full expanse of my, like, conscious, like, lifetime, and, like, how that relates to the primeval emptiness of the universe, the original primeval emptiness of the universe that is me, and the, like, immortalization of my identity that will, like, permeate the future. Like, that's what it is. That's what the three spirits are in the Sandcraft Online server.